Hello, LP aficionados. I've been cataloging over 2,000 of my records for my own personal use. Plus, when it comes time to sell them, it'll be easier to be able to identify them quickly to potential buyers. Right now, you're looking at Picasa, an incredibly wonderful program, free from Google. I suggest you all get a Google account. You don't have to use Gmail, but you can use as your name. You can use whatever you want to. Most people use their current email address. Anyway, get a Google account, and there'll be a lot of Google going on in this demonstration. Okay, so I've taken pictures of almost 3,000 of my albums, and I have a video on YouTube. And if you do the search for square format from digital camera, that's square format from digital camera, you'll find how I set up my camera. The most important thing is to avoid reflections. Many of the album covers are glossy or they're covered with shrink wrap, and how you do that is quite tricky. The second problem is how to change all those rectangular images from digital cameras into square images. Now, like in any program, Photoshop on down, whatever's built into Microsoft or to Apple, you can crop like this. You know, you can just crop that. I apply that. Okay, so now there's my square image. I wasn't able to get particularly perfect color rendition from the ones I did, and you can tune them manually with fill light or highlights or shadows or color temperature. But I found in Google Picasa that I'm Feeling Lucky does an amazing job. You won't see it on this camera. I'm going to undo that right now, and I'm going to undo the crop also, because what we're going to do is we're going to take this set of one album set I have is called Late Rock, and it's basically compilations with all different kinds of bands or musicians on it. And by late rock, I mean anything like actually post-Louie Louie period. Before that, I call it early rock, which includes blues, but that's just my particular thing. So I've got all these images. They're all about a megabyte, way too big to put in the database. I'm using Word for the database. Yeah, so here's the database. I have like the image of the cover. This happens to be a box set with 15 LPs in it, the name, some of the characteristics of it, and then over here I put links to all different things that are on the internet, such as Discogs, DISCOGS.com, which is very good. Sometimes I put Wikipedia information on there. I also have a link to what's inside the box down here. You can't see it so well. Or I have in Word, you do a control and click. I'll have to take my hand off the camera for a second. Control and click. And now it's going to take me to Picasa web albums on the internet. Yeah. And so that is everything that's inside this box, and there's all 15 albums there, the sleeves, and these are about megabyte files also. So when I click on some detail like this and then I blow it up, you can't see it here, but it's quite readable. I can't bring it in close enough to see the detail, but it's quite you just drag it around and find. So not only does it give you the track listing, but it gives you all the information. Okay, view all, there we are again. Anyway, that's Google Picasa web albums, right? So the link to this album, I'll do a, you can't see it, do a link, you get the link. You can either get the link at the top or the link here. You can copy it, copy the link, and go into Google URL shortener, which is better than any of the other ones I've been using, because I'll paste in the long, very long address, shorten it, and you get this right here. Now the good thing about this thing is that your history goes on forever. You can find ones 7 days ago. I had three hits off of this one. It shows you the graph about when it's most popular, the hits. So basically, it's great if you send a link to a friend and you can accuse them later. You never open my links. Okay, anyway, back to images. Okay, so where are we? That's Word. Don't need that right now. This is Picasa. Don't need that right now. What we need is the actual folder. This is all my music here in this folder, which I've called Album Pictures. And the one we're going to do today is late rock, which you saw already in Picasa. But this is where the files are. Picasa doesn't have any files. Picasa basically goes through your computer, finds all your images, leaves them exactly where you put them. Whatever changes you make to it, that's what's in the file, but it makes a backup. It keeps all the original ones in a place where you can't mess with them unless you really need them. So that's really, really nice. Now, what I do is I make two folders to go inside this folder, which I've called Late Rock. And these are going to be called JPEG Crops Late Rock. Now, JPEG Crops is the program I use. You can find the link in that same YouTube video that I mentioned at the first part of this video. I use that free program to batch crop. So instead of cropping one at a time, you can do 200 at a time. The key is, of course, that all your albums have to be taken in exactly the same place, the same location. The camera can't move. The album can't move except for when a new album is put in the same place. The second folder I've put here is called Small Late Rock. Now, what these are going to be 30 to 50 megabyte, I mean, sorry, 30 to 50 K kilobyte small tiny images for the database. I don't want to use huge images here for obvious reasons. I don't want this database to be 20 gigabytes. Okay, so I make small images here, and if I need to have them bigger, then you can make a link to either the internet, to Picasa web albums, or somewhere on your hard drive, whatever. Okay, so now we're going to open up JPEG Crops shortcut. It's going to ask you. It's going to ask you if you want to run it. The guy who built this hasn't worked on it for years, and it's amazing how well it works. Oh, always ask before opening this file. I'll just unclick that. Okay, run this. It's a safe piece of software. Okay, now we're getting just to a white screen. Let me see. It was too big there. Down at the bottom, it'll say to directory. So where do I want these images to go once I, well, let's open the images first. Okay, so we're going to open the images. We're going to find that album picks, late rock. Okay, so there's my pictures. I'm going to select the first one, go down to the last one, do a shift. So I select them all. And then I'm going to go down to the crops, the JPEG crops, and open images. Okay. Oh, I got to do open here first. Okay, open. Okay, now it's creating thumbnails. Okay, so there's the images. Now you go down to the bottom where it says, where do you want them put after it crops them all? Well, I don't like to mess with the original images. So And if you just have them go in the same folder, it's just going to name them whatever the long name is. In this case, it's just the name off the camera, P103022, and then it'll just do a -1, which is horrible because it mixes in with the other one. So make a separate folder. I'm going to find that folder now that I've already named album picks, late rock, Jpegcrops late rock. Okay, so now I've selected where they're going to go. Okay, now you take the first frame in this whole thing, which has all the images. The first frame is your keyframe. Now they have all these different aspect ratios you can use. None of them are square. Hard to believe, none of them are square. So I just made one called test, and it's just a square one. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to make it too small, first of all, and then just drag it to one corner. I like to leave just a little black, and then bring it down. That's about right. It's not perfect, but it's okay. Now, the other images are still the way the first one was set up, and that's no good. So what you do is you go to edit and synchronize crops. You can't see it, but it's synchronized crops. Okay. Oh, I changed it in the meantime because I was trying to show you something. Never mind. Let's do it again. Okay. Make it square just a little, and then you can move it around. You know, so move it around. There we go. Okay, now I'll synchronize crops. There they are. Okay, now they're all synchronized. Now what I do is I just go down to the bottom, see how they are. They're all pretty good. They're great, in fact. Okay, so once you've synchronized all your crops, then you just do crop all images, and one by one, they're going to disappear, and they're going into that folder now that they're cropped. These images were 1.1 to 1.3 megabytes, and when they end up in the folder, they've lost like what it looks like at least 20% of the file through cropping. So they're now about 800K, 800 or 900K, which is good enough. You saw the detail of blowing up the back of an album cover with like 8-point font on it. It worked. Okay, so we're finished with Jpegcrops. We can close that. And now they've all gone into the folder, the Jpegcrops Late Rock folder. There they are. Okay, now we go into Picasa and we look up, I'm going to type up here Jpeg. Okay, Jpegcrops, early rock, late rock. There we go. Oh, it's still putting them in. Yeah, you can see this little thing down there. It's still putting them in. Okay, they're all in there now. 13. Oh, no, it's still putting them in. Yeah, one at a time. It's still putting them in. I don't know how many there are. The window will disappear when they finish. Okay, that's them. They're all in there. Okay, so what I do now, these are all cropped. They're all large. What I'm going to do is, you can either select them all this way or just go to, they're already open. So I'm just going to, instead of all selecting them, do a select all pictures. I'll do that. Okay, I'll select all the pictures in that folder. And then I'm going to do this thing called in picture up here. Picture. I'm going to do batch edit, and you can do rotations, contrast, colors, sepia, sharpen, warm, film grain, black and white, automatic red eye connection. But I'm going to do I'm feeling lucky, and it's just worked out so well for me. So here we go. And then you'll see it processing this. And you may be able to see on this. With this camera, you may be able to see. Oh, you see, they're just brighter. They're much better. They're much more More that way. Okay, so now they're all corrected and they're in that folder that way. I can save them now if I want to. Save them to disk, might as well. And then I'm going to take these same images and make them smaller. So I go to File and Export Pictures to Folder. I choose the folder, which is going to be Album Pics, Late Rock, Small Late Rock, okay? And I'm just to putting them down to 200 pixels at maximum image quality, 200 pixels. You can increase that, you know, and you just have to figure out, you know, what size is good enough for you. I don't know why I put in 200. 200 seems fine. I'll have to, just a second. Okay, so I put in 200 again. You can add watermarks now if you want to. Okay, so now I'm going to export all those. And you see it's busy exporting them. Okay, so now we're finished with Picasa. It's still working on them. And here we go. Okay, so there's these are the original photos in the thing. These are the cropped ones that are still very large. So I use those to throw on Picasa web albums. And the way you do that, okay, and then one more thing, back to the small ones. The small ones I'll use to drag and drop into Word, into those little boxes that show the picture. So let's go back to Picasa. Now they're all selected. These again, these are the JPEG crops, late rock. So these are the bigger images. I think if you click one, you can see what size it is. This is 1.1 megabytes. Okay, this one right here, and this one is what? 980, 933. So they're all a little different. So I'm going to select them all, select all, and I'm going to put them on the web now, on Picasa web album. So you go down to, sorry, you go down to upload. Where is it? There it is, upload. And I'm going to change the name of the album to, take my camera down for a second while I type. Yeah, I'm just going to call that the web album. The Picasa web album is going to be called Late Rock. I'm keeping them 1600 pixels. You have a choice of original size, which would be, you know, like we said, 1.1 megabytes, or I find the recommended size is good enough. I'm doing anyone with this link can view them, although you can choose public on the web, or you can make it private that somebody has to be signed in and you can assign them. So it's very good for security, but I don't care. Anyone with the link can look at them, big deal. Okay, and now I'm just going to upload them. Here's the upload button. Okay, so it's uploading. And there's 22 images. And that's about it. From there, I'm just going to go to the web now and go back to, let's say you need to, let's view this whole thing called the Atlantic box set. You can download them. To your desktop, anybody can download them that wants to, or you can restrict that too if you want to, but that's what it is. So here's all the ones, you know, some private stuff, and then also all the different these are all box sets. Elvis, Jerry Lee Lewis, blues, lots of blues, Zappa, strange stuff. some picture discs that I wanted details of in case I sell them, some 45s, some very oddball stuff down here, art records, very small printings of those. They might be worth it. And I think that's about all you need to know. Let's see if the new one has come on yet. I don't see late rock yet. Let me refresh this. No, it's still loading onto the late rock. Oh, view online. Okay, let's find it. Okay, so there they are. And now if somebody needs to see all the details of, let's say, this album, then they can blow it up and, you know, see what this album was all about. And again, you can get the link to that. You can embed it. You can hide the album link. You can do the image only. The size of what you want to put as a posting it somewhere, whether it's eBay or some chat room or whatever. Choose your size, 800 pixels to 144 pixels. All kinds of things. So, good luck. And that's it.